Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to see how column chromatography can be used to separate the compounds from mixture. So here the aim of experiment is separation of compounds by column chromatography. So this is basically a demonstration experiment in the syllabus. So these are the requirements to perform the experiment. We require a glass column, then we require a cotton to hold the stationary phase. We require red and blue stamp padding. So here this is used as a sample and we have mixed them together. We require a silica gel, which is widely used stationary material. And here the commercially available silica gel specially made for column chromatography is used, that is having mesh size 200 to 400. Then we do require bigger and lengthier glass rod to pack the stationary phase inside the column. We require test tube to collect the fractions, and we require solvent system which we have developed, that is ethanol and distilled water. And then rotary evaporator or vacuum rotary evaporator is optional. So if you want to reuse the solvents again and again, so we can use a vacuum rotary evaporator. The principle of column chromatography is based on the adsorption mechanism. So we know that we are using a stationary phase which is inert in nature, and this stationary phase is packed inside the column. And then we are using a mobile phase which is liquid in nature, which is continuously poured and moving through the column due to the gravitational force. Okay, so we know that in the theory of chromatography we have studied, the discovery of chromatography itself has been started with the column chromatography. And here in column chromatography, the sample will have the affinity towards the stationary phase as well as towards the mobile phase. So based on their adsorption affinity, the sample will migrate from the column. Okay, so each sample will have its own adsorption affinity to the stationary and mobile phase, and that is how, based on their adsorption affinities, they will be eluted or they will be separated from the column, and we can able to separate them from the mixture. So these are the experimental steps to perform the column chromatography. So first thing is that we need to select the solvent system, and that is done with the help of thin layer chromatography. So we can take our mixture, we can spot it on TLC plate, and then we can play with different solvent systems, and we can optimize the solvent system. Okay, so we will get the appropriate RF value for the compounds which we want to separate. Once we do that, then we can pack the column. Okay, so we have to decide whether we are going for isocratic elution or gradient elution. If you are going for isocratic elution, so whatever solvent system you have selected, same solvent system you have to use it for preparing a slurry of silica. Okay, if you are going for gradient, then you can go for only one type of solvent system, that means only one single solvent, and then you can gradually keep on increasing the polarity by adding or changing the composition of your solvent system as you proceed for the elution. Then we need to prepare a sample which we are going to discuss in the coming slides. Then we need to load the sample on the packed column, then we have to perform the elution by pouring the mobile phase, and then we need to identify the sample. So usually in this case the sample is visible, it is colored sample, as it is red and blue ink, so we can easily make out where the sample is there, and then we can take or collect the fractions in the test tubes. If the sample is invisible, we can use different methods. One of the widely used method is using the UV chamber or UV light. So with the help of UV light, whatever fractions are eluting, we'll spot it on TLC and we'll compare with the mixture, and then when they are matching, then we can collect those fractions and you can evaporate the solvent. Okay, and then finally the evaporation of solvent. Okay, so these are the experimental steps. And for this particular experiment, here we can see in TLC we have spotted here the mixture on the baseline, and the two spots we got on the TLC plate. Here we used the solvent system ethanol and distilled water. So here the ratio was 9:1, 9 ml was ethanol and 1 ml was the distilled water. So we could see here the red ink has higher RF value, and the bottom one there was the blue ink, okay, which has been evaporated here. Now we have selected as ethanol and water. So with that we can pack the column.
Okay. So our aim of experiment is to separate the mixture of compounds using column chromatography. So in theory we have studied column chromatography is widely used to purify or to isolate the compounds which are in the mixture form. So for doing this experiment, the requirements are, we require a glass column, then we require a stand to hold the column vertically. Here we are taking solvent system as ethyl acetate, ethyl alcohol and our water, distilled water. As a mixture we have taken sample of two inks, our regular stamp pad inks, that is blue ink and red ink. So these ink we have already mixed in this beaker and it has been adsorbed on the silica. We require stationary phase in column chromatography, so we are using silica gel 200 to 400 mesh size. This is widely used for doing a column chromatography. And then we require the funnel and the simple other glassware like test tubes and so on. So in column chromatography, the packing of stationary phase is very important. So the column should be completely dry. So we have cleaned this column and we have taken a dry column. Column packing can be done by two ways. So one way of packing column is wet packing, and the other way of packing column is the dry packing. Okay, so we are going to load the stationary phase inside this particular column. So this is called as column packing. So we are going to insert the cotton, or you can also use the sand. So this is just to trap or hold the stationary phase inside the column, because the particle size of the stationary phase is very fine and it can come out of the column very easily. So to retain the stationary phase inside this glass column, we have put the cotton. And now we are going to load our stationary phase with the help of solvent. So this column can be packed by two methods. One method is the wet packing and the other method is dry packing. So today we are going to demonstrate this experiment with the wet packing method. So I am adding little amount of solvent in this. So this cotton might have some entrapped air, so this air can be removed with adding little amount of solvent. Once you remove the air, then we can prepare the slurry of this silica, which is the stationary phase here. So I am preparing the slurry in ethyl alcohol. We can mix this silica and make it in a slurry. Can add the solvent. So make the silica slurry. Again mix it properly. And once this silica slurry is prepared, then we have to pour this silica slurry. Okay, so slowly you can add the silica slurry and open the tap. So because of the cotton, the silica is retained, or the stationary phase is retained. Now we can take the glass rod, linear glass rod, and just we have to tap this silica slurry so that it has to settle down. So this is how we are packing the column. So we'll open the tap and allow it to drip. So meanwhile, the silica is getting settled. Now after 10 minutes we can see the silica slurry has been settled down and our column is packed now. Now what we have to do, we have to add our sample or the mixture. Now this is nothing but the mixture of red and blue ink which has been adsorbed on the silica, the same stationary phase what we are using here for the separation. Okay, so now I am going to add my sample or the mixture on this particular column. So very gently we can add our sample here. We have added our sample. Now we have to allow this sample to settle down. Once the sample settles down, then again we will be adding a small layer, approximately 1 centimeter layer of again stationary phase, so that when we pour the mobile phase, the sample layer will not get disturbed. Because if we are not adding the top layer of silica again, then what will happen? The moment you pour the solvent system, the sample or the mixture will get disturbed and that will affect the separation. Now we can see here the red ink is getting eluted, right? So now our sample was in the mixture form, but now what is happening, the red ink is having lesser affinity to this particular stationary phase, that is silica gel. So that is why it is moving faster. So once it settles down, then we will add the silica slurry and we will start the elution. Okay, let's start. Now our sample is separating and now we are going to add some silica slurry on the top of the sample. Okay, so we can add just approximately 0.5 or 1 centimeter of this silica bed, so that when we pour a fresh solvent system, that is not getting disturbed. So at present we are only eluting with ethanol, so that is a isochoretic elution. We are not changing the composition of solvent, but now we are going to add water in this particular solvent system. Okay, so once this solvent will come down, then we will take the ethanol and then we are going to add some amount of water. So in other words, we are going to increase the polarity. So we can say here this red ink is moving faster because it has the less affinity towards the stationary phase. So if I add or increase the polarity, so both will move faster. Okay, now we can see as the time proceeds, the two inks are separating from each other. The red ink is moving faster. Now we can use the test tubes and we have to collect the fractions as it is visible to our eyes. So we can arrange the height of the column and we can mark these test tubes sequentially as 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we can see the red ink is getting eluted. So once the red ink is eluted, then we know only blue ink is remaining. So we can increase the polarity of the solvent system. So so far we are using only ethanol, so we can increase 1 or 2% of water. So we may take little amount of water. So we can take 98 ml of ethanol and 2 ml of water, we can mix together as a solvent system and then we can elute that. So we can see here, now the test tube is collecting the fraction of red ink. So this red ink we can collect and then we can evaporate easily the ethanol. So ethanol can be easily evaporated. So under vacuum rotary evaporator we can evaporate these eluents taking into RBF and the vacuum rotary evaporator can be used and the solvent can be evaporated under reduced pressure. Okay, so this is how we can separate the mixtures into individual components.
So this is how we can enter the result. So number of compounds which we separated, these are the two compounds, one is red and other one is a blue ink. And what compounds we isolated, that is again red and blue ink. So we can take a reference red and blue ink, we can spot it on TLC, and then whatever fractions we eluted that we can spot on TLC as a sample, and then we can compare it, the RF value. Okay, so that is how we can identify. We already seen one experiment, and then confirmation of isolated compound. Okay, so that that's what I told you. You can either match with the RF value by running a TLC with sample and reference, and in this case it is clearly visible because they are colored spot, so we can easily make out. Okay, so that's all with the column chromatography. Thank you.